Hi everyone, I'm David Wojcik and this is MBOT TV. Stories we covered this week, MBOT delivers a message to council regarding costly development charges. We also weighed in on the regional governance consultations being conducted by the province. Skills Ontario had another amazing competition this week, and the Premier visits Mississauga-based Nova Nordisk to share in an important announcement affecting scholarships for Mississauga students. Welcome to MBOT TV, a weekly recap of what happened in business at the Mississauga Board of Trade and around the city of Mississauga. Let's dive in. First up, our series on the corporate execution gap. Here's Fred Pitsadny from Focus Management with our Guru Gap tip of the week on why you, as the CEO, need to work on your business and how it affects your execution strategy.
Thanks, David. As the leader, you need to be more focused on the future direction of your organization. Your people are quite capable and should be making the operational decisions. Organization leaders need to own and take charge of the strategic planning process and the outcomes. Your priority is making sure that what really matters most gets done. To do that, you need to make sure three things are in place. Number one, clear direction. Your mission, vision, goals, and strategies need to be documented and understood by everyone at all levels. Number two, aligned objectives. People at all levels must have specific, measurable outcome accountabilities that are aligned with the company strategy and to each other. Number three, clear roles. People who are crystal clear on the decisions and actions for which they are accountable and the explicit authority to make them happen. Unclear roles are the most common blockage to successful strategy execution. With clear direction, aligned objectives, and clear roles, you will gain a competitive execution advantage. Now, who doesn't want that? Make it happen. Back to you, David.
Thanks, Fred. If you want to stay up to date on current issues affecting business leaders, tune in to Your Business on Saga 960 AM, Fridays at 11 AM. A one-hour business show where I interview industry experts on everything from motivating employees to boosting your bottom line. You can also listen online at www.saga960am.ca. This Friday at 11 a.m., our guests include Rocco Rossi, CEO of the Ontario Chamber of Commerce, the author of Magnetic Entrepreneur Robert Moore, and Earl Rich, a professional image consultant who helps us understand what business casual should mean in the office. Tune in and be the first to know what's on the top of mind with business leaders across the province. Still to come is our political update with Brad Butt, with trade changes affecting business in Mississauga, and our upcoming events listing with Stephanie Giorgio. But first, are you looking for ways to save money on your employee benefits? The Chamber Plan can help.
The Chamber's Plan now offers employee benefit programs with greater selection, higher coverage levels, and more value than ever before. Take another look and see why we're the choice of more small businesses than any other plan in Canada. The Chamber's Plan, it's for your benefit.
The 2019 edition of MBOT's annual magazine and directory is in the works. This directory is an excellent way for you to gain recognition for your business. For more information, call 905-273-6151, press 0, and speak to your membership services manager today. Now for our political update, here's our Vice President of Government and Stakeholder Relations, Brad Butt. Brad?
Well, thanks, David. Premier Doug Ford was in Mississauga last Thursday visiting MBOT member Novo Nordisk's office to help launch our sister association, Life Sciences Ontario, scholarship program. This is a great initiative of the Mississauga-based life sciences companies to help support new workers into this extremely important sector of Mississauga's economy. MBOT offers its support and congratulations for this outstanding program. For more information on the LSO scholarship program, please go to the website that is listed on the screen. Statistics Canada announced last Friday that employment in Ontario increased by 47,100 in April. The gains included 10,100 full-time positions and 37,000 part-time jobs. Ontario's Open for Business Action Plan has set two targets for 2020 to help businesses keep grow and create good jobs, to save Ontario companies at least $400 million per year in the cost of complying with regulations, and to reduce the number of regulatory requirements affecting businesses by at least 25%. Well, the Regional Governance Review Panel visited Peel Region last week, and our CEO, David Wojcik, addressed the meeting, reinforcing MBOT's position that if the Government of Ontario decides to dissolve the Region of Peel government, that the City of Mississauga should become a single-tier, standalone municipality. Meanwhile, I appeared before Mississauga City Council last Wednesday on its review of the Development Charges Bylaw. Development charges help pay for growth and new infrastructure that is needed as a result of new developments. The city is required to pass a bylaw every 5 years to implement the development charges. While the City of Mississauga is preparing to create Tourism Mississauga, a new agency that will guide Mississauga's tourism strategy. As it prepares a plan, a public meeting will be held, including the all-important hotel and motel stakeholders, to seek input on the mandate and role of this organization. With more than $10 million raised annually through the municipal accommodation tax in Mississauga, a new tourism agency must be guided by the businesses collecting and remitting this tax. The Canadian Chamber of Commerce has launched Vote Prosperity 2019 in advance of the October federal election to draw attention to all the political parties and candidates, the issues of greatest concern to Canada's business community. The plan focuses on taxation, regulatory issues, trade, SMEs, skills, a connected Canada, and pharmacare. To learn more about the campaign, please visit voteprosperityca.ca. Well, the Canadian Chamber of Commerce President Perrin Beattie has written an open letter to the Prime Minister about Canada's relations with China. Mr. Beattie states, "Here at home, we should use the legally permissible tools at our disposal to ensure Canadian business interests are protected. For example, we must take a balanced approach to trade remedy measures and not hesitate to leverage what is allowable under our trade commitments in the areas of procurement contracts. It is vital for our businesses to be able to compete on a reciprocal level and level the playing field to reduce disparities in markets. In terms of our bilateral actions, the current impasse is fundamentally political. Scientific exchanges or the appointment of an ambassador are helpful, but only a small portion of the total equation. We need political engagement at the highest level, and I urge you to seek a bilateral meeting with President Xi Jinping at the G20 summit. Back to you, David.
Thanks, Brad. With a listing of our upcoming events, here's our events manager, Stephanie Giorgio. Stephanie.
Thanks, David. And here's what's coming up at your Mississauga Board of Trade. On May 14th, we are at Lionhead Golf and Country Club for the Women's Leadership Event. Join Carol Stewart, President and CEO of Kellogg's Canada, as she shares her insights and authentic leadership philosophy along with her actionable lessons to step up your leadership game. On May 23rd, we are at Dave & Buster's for Good Evening Mississauga. Come out and connect with Mississauga businesses. This evening will provide you with the light snacks, adult beverages, and lots of opportunities to start building important business relationships. On May 31st, we welcome the Honorable Todd Smith, Ontario Minister of Economic Development, Job Creation, and Trade at the Renaissance by the Creek. The minister will be sharing the government's Open for Business plan, efforts to reduce red tape, and regulatory burden and keeping Ontario competitive. On June 5th, Membership Matters is at MBOT, a session for new members to discover all the great benefits that your Mississauga Board of Trade has to offer. Seasoned members are always welcome to stop by for a refresher. On June 24th, we tee off at Lionhead Golf for 9 holes of fun. Whether you're a golfer or not, this event has something for you. Can't make golf? No problem. Join us for dinner, big prizes, and our legendary silent auction. Grand prize of a big screen TV and a live auction for two airline tickets. Back to you, David.
Thanks, Stephanie. If you have any questions about how to make a nomination for our Awards of Excellence, register for an event, increase awareness for your business, or have your company featured on MBOT TV, contact your membership services manager by calling 905-273-6151. Press 0 and get connected. Details about these stories and events are available at www.mbot.com. Until next week, this is David Voyager, wishing you continued success in your business.